Welcome to you all, wherever you're joining us from, to this live stream service from the five churches of the Whitney and Minster Lovell Benefice. It is the second Sunday after Trinity. You might like to know that today the St. Siegfried's Trust pilgrimage begins with a service at 10:30 now at Deddington, led by Bishop Stephen, and then Hugh and Bethany are walking from Deddington to Woodstock today. And also, just to let you know, the sad news that Dennis Woodhams died this morning. So we give thanks for his life and ministry among us. Pray for his, that he may rest in peace and rise in glory. We give thanks for Dennis's life today. And so we begin our liturgy this morning. Glory to the holy and undivided Trinity.
God, who is three in one and one in three.
Who is beyond us, among us, within us.
Who was and is to come, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The seed of your kingdom is forever being sown into our lives, our world, O God. But it doesn't always take root. Sometimes it fails to find a place to grow. So in silence, let us call to mind our sins. We confess the times we fail to involve ourselves in planting any seeds of faith in the lives of others. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We confess the times we are hard and resistant, like a well-trodden path, where old habits, old systems, and old patterns of thinking keep your message from growing. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
We confess the times our desires and self-absorption tangle like thorns around your grace and choke it into silence. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by the Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. O God, we gather together in your presence with expectation, hungry for an encounter with you, eager to hear your word. Open our eyes and ears to the presence of your Holy Spirit. May the seeds of your word scattered among us this morning fall on fertile soil. May they take root in our hearts and lives and produce an abundant harvest of good words and deeds. We pray this in the name of Jesus Christ, our teacher and our Lord. Amen. And now Jill is going to read from the second letter to Paul to the Corinthians.
For the love of Christ urges us on, because we are convinced that one has died for all. Therefore, all have died. And he died for all, so that those who live might live no longer for themselves, but for him who died and was raised for them. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from a human point of view. Even though we once knew Christ from a human point of view, we know him no longer in that way. So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, "The kingdom of God is as if someone would scatter seed on the ground and would sleep and rise night and day, and the seed would sprout and grow. He does not know how. The earth produces of itself, first the stalk, then the head, then the full grain in the head. But when the grain is ripe, at once he goes in with his sickle, because the harvest has come." He also said, "With what can we compare the kingdom of God, or what parable will be used for it? It is like a mustard seed, which, when sown upon the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on earth. Yet, when it is sown, it grows up and becomes the greatest of all shrubs, and puts forth large branches, so that the birds of the air can make nests in its shade." With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to hear it. He did not speak to them except in parables, but he explained everything in private to his disciples. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. Friends, some of you will be familiar with godly play. And Joanna has long been an advocate for it within the benefice. Sally and I have been trained in it as well as one or two others within the benefice. And Sally has prepared a video for us this morning, which draws on directly on our gospel passage for today of the mustard seed. So in a moment, James is going to play that video for us. At the end of that video, there are a series of questions. And as Sally asks each of us a question, there'll then be a pause as we have had a bit of time to reflect on that question. The whole premise of godly play is that there aren't right and wrong answers. It's not asking simplistic questions, for example, how many loaves and fishes were there? And you either know the answer or you don't. It's exploring spirituality and what does that mean for us and where is God in our lives? So I'm going to hand over to James at this stage and invite you to share in those questions as we come to the end of the video.
There was once someone who said such wonderful things and did such amazing things that people followed him. As they followed him, they heard him speaking about a kingdom, but it was not like the kingdom they lived in. It was not like any kingdom they had ever visited. It was not even like any kingdom anyone had ever heard of. They couldn't help it. They had to ask him, "What is the kingdom of heaven like?" One time, when they asked him that, he said, "The kingdom of heaven is like when a person took the tiniest of all the seeds, a grain of mustard seed, a seed so small that if I had one on my finger, you would not be able to see it. The person put the tiny seed into the ground, and it began to grow. The shrub grew so big, it was like a little tree, and the birds of the air came. And they made their nests there. Now I wonder if the person who planted the tiny seed in the ground has a name. I wonder if the person was happy to see the birds coming. I wonder what the person was doing while the shrub was growing. I wonder if the person could take the shrub like a tree and push it all back down inside the seed. I wonder if the seed was happy while it was growing. I wonder if the birds have names. I wonder if they were happy to find the tree. I wonder what the tree could really be. I wonder if you have ever come close to this kind of tree. I wonder what the nests could really be. I wonder where this whole place could really be.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him, all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
United in the faith and as members of the Kingdom of God, we turn to the Lord with all our needs, saying, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the Church throughout the world, that all Christian communities gathered as the body of Christ may truly become part of the Kingdom of God. In following Christ in all things, we unite every nation of ethnic origin and tradition, producing the fruit of faith. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
As disciples of Jesus, we all pray for God's kingdom to be a reality in our lives. With wholehearted faith, we pray that we may learn to understand and accept God's will, and be generous in our call to be communities of mercy and kindness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for missionaries today as they engage with peoples of different cultures and faiths. May their faith and love of God be strengthened as they work to help establish God's reign on earth. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the world's leaders and diplomats, that all nations may work together for justice and to build a world of peace, hope, and care for the environment. We pray especially for the G7 summit and for the leaders and advisors gathered in the UK. We pray too for all scientists and statisticians as we work out next steps for the United Kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. Let us remember the poor and marginalized, those who have no one to speak for them, those without the means to feed themselves and their families. May the world's wealth and abundance be justly shared with all who are in need. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all who are sick and for all who are in hospital, that they may be aware that God is with them in their troubles. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In the silence of our hearts, let us pray for those who have asked us for prayers. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Gracious God, you are the God of the living and not of the dead. Breathe your spirit into all who have died and draw them into your everlasting life in the land of the living. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In a moment of silence, we offer our own prayers and petitions to the throne of grace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And so we unite our prayers with all the faithful throughout time and eternity, uniting ours with those of Mary and all the saints as we pray. Merciful and loving God,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Jesus said, "Love one another as I have loved you, so you are to love one another." The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a virtual sign of peace. Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
We praise you and we bless you, holy and gracious God, source of the abundant life from before time you made ready the creation. Your Spirit moved over the deep and brought all things into being, sun, moon and stars, earth, winds and waters, and every living thing. You made us in your image and taught us to walk in your ways. But we rebelled against you and wandered far away. And yet as a mother cares for her children, you would not forget us. Time and again, you called us to live in the fullness of your love. And so this day we join with saints and angels in the chorus of praise that rings through eternity, lifting our voices to magnify you as we say, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Glory and praise to you, holy and living God, to deliver us from the power of sin and death and to reveal the riches of your grace. You looked with favor upon Mary, your willing servant, that she might conceive and bear a son, Jesus, the Holy Child of God, living among us. Jesus loved us. He broke bread with outcasts and sinners, healed the sick and proclaimed good news to the poor. He yearned to draw all the world to himself, yet we were heedless of his call to walk in love. Then the time came for him to complete upon the cross the sacrifice of his life and to be glorified by you. On the night before he died for us, Jesus was at table with his friends. He took bread, gave thanks to you, broke it, gave it to them and said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. As supper was ending, Jesus took the cup of wine. Again, he gave thanks to you, gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for remembrance of me. Now gathered at your table, O God of all creation, and remembering Christ crucified and risen, who was and is to come, we offer to you our gifts of bread and wine and ourselves a living sacrifice. Pour out your Spirit upon these gifts that they may be the body and blood of Christ. Breathe your Spirit over the whole earth and make us your new creation, the body of Christ, given for the world you have made. In the fullness of time, bring us with Mary, the Mother of God, John the Baptist, John the Evangelist, Kenelm, and all your saints, from every tribe and language and people and nation, to feast at the banquet prepared from the foundation of the world, through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, to you be honor, glory, and praise forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Made in God's image and formed by God's love, let us pray in the Spirit as Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and ever. Amen.
Jesus, we believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. We love you above all things and we desire you in our souls. Though we cannot receive you in bread and wine, may we now still receive you in our hearts. Trusting in your gracious presence, we welcome and embrace you, and we rejoice in the promise that nothing can separate us from your love. Amen.
We pray together. Loving God, we thank you for joining us together around the supper of your Son. Sustain us in your Spirit, that we may serve you here on earth until our joy is complete in heaven, and we share in the eternal banquet with Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen.
May Jesus so generously and graciously in your life to fortify you for hard times and costly discipleship that you may endure. And may the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Okay.
When the best of me is barely breathing, when I'm not somebody I believe in, hold on to me.